it shows Amazon's great ambitions to dominate a business that presently Netflix is really owning, and that is the streaming of video to users. But they're trying to do it with a hardware device. I think they've recognized they've had a difficulty getting into the home in ways that Netflix has made better partnerships. But they come at this with a great advantage, which is that they have been selling video, principally as the largest seller of DVDs, but they've been doing video and content deals for a long time, and they also know what consumers want more than anyone else out there by virtue of the purchases and the reviews that they have on the Amazon website. So with this piece of hardware, they think they can really give a boost to their Prime video service.
Paul, some people question whether Amazon should be trying to take on Apple and Netflix at the same time, which is effectively right. what they're doing. Do you feel good about it? Do you feel good about what Jeff Bezos is doing because you've seen how successful he made the Kindle Fire?
Yeah, I think it's just another example of a big tech company getting into the TV business, which, 10 years ago, a lot of people thought the TV business was a dying business. But here we have all these big tech companies trying to get into the TV business, sensing that streaming really is a huge business and is getting even, bigger business in terms of users and in terms of advertising dollars. So I think what Amazon is saying here is, listen, we certainly have the capital to get into this business. We would like to get closer to our customers. We would, like to know more about our customers. We would like this service to really help us sell our Prime delivery service, which at the end of the day will drive our e-commerce business. So in no way, shape, or form, I think is Amazon shifting its focus away from its core e-commerce business. They're always looking about ways to drive it. And Amazon Prime has been, one of those ways to drive better traffic to e-commerce site.
Who's this biggest threat to?
I think certainly for Netflix, just from the stream, if you'd want to look at it narrowly, just the streaming online video business, who's the incumbent player, if you will, who's the first player in there with the biggest market share, and that's Netflix. So I think Netflix investors, the shorts in this stock, which have been getting killed over the last couple of years, I think the short thesis has always been, listen, there's really no barriers to entry here. All you need to do is write a big check to Hollywood to get the content and then just stream it. And so now you've got Apple, big checkbook, Amazon, big checkbook. Who knows what Google wants to do with Chromecast? So, I think the potential issue here is what does Netflix do in response?
But, Corey, is there a positive that, in general, as Paul said, people thought the TV business was dead. People are watching more TV now than ever. 10 years ago, my husband, the Tiger Dog, wasn't going home on a Thursday night to watch Friends, but now he's looking for shows. He cares about TV. Is there a silver lining that this is all good for content providers?
Maybe you guys are just old and boring now. Have you considered that possibility?
You know what, Corey? Takes one to know one. Saying.
there's a wonderful argument. Maybe this may be the golden age of television. There's been some wonderful commentary in The New Yorker and beyond about what's available for adults to watch on TV and how maybe better than ever before. And part of that is the economics. It's a lot more money going towards high-end premium content for television that maybe The Sopranos might have started an idea of what TV might be. But there's a lot of spending on things by Netflix with House of Cards, by Amazon with their series. And let's not forget Comcast in here as well. And one of the things that this box allows Amazon to do is have more control of the user experience, so that when you have Comcast trying to merge with Time Warner and control the experience of cable TV in 19 of the 20 largest markets in America, if that deal were to go through, Amazon can look at that as a threat, as Comcast would then be in a position to make their service slower. Here they are trying to get out ahead of that with a box. They're talking about speed. We see Netflix striking deals with Comcast to make their service faster than competitors at Comcast homes. And so I think that's the other dynamic at play here.
Paul, what happens to exclusivity? Because if you like Game of Thrones, you got no choice but to watch HBO.
Right.
And for that, you need a cable subscription. If you want to watch...
Or you need somebody's HBO Go login, which is how half the young people watch
right,
honest.
Or if you want to watch, the back catalog of Breaking Bad, you've got to have a Netflix subscription.
Right.
Jeff Bezos doesn't want to share, but nobody wants to have an Apple TV, a Chromecast, and whatever the Fire TV that Amazon's selling.
That's right. I think it comes back to who are the real winners here. And the argument that we've been making for a long time is the real winners here are Hollywood. The people producing the content, because now you have not just the three broadcast networks, not just the 500 cable networks, but now you have all these streaming services, really bidding for your content.
Which is great if you're in Hollywood. Right. It sucks if you're the consumer.
That's right. So you find yourself, that's why I think that, the cable model, arguably, with this TV everywhere concept, concept whereby if you pay for HBO or Showtime or Cinemax, the folks that are creating a lot of original content, you can in fact take that on any device you want, anywhere you want. Now the new issue coming into the marketplace is streaming video, and Netflix really kind of, you know, reset the deck, if you will, by getting into original programming with, you know, House of Cards, because that is a place, you know, if you want to see House of Cards, you have to go there. It is outside of the cable ecosystem, and that is a concern for some of the big media companies.